Hey guys, it's Steve Frag, and today I'm going to show you how to do this with absolute ease, because it should always be simple. And yeah, let's just get started. And if you were wondering, no, that wasn't edited in. Yes, it was all live in OBS Studio. And yes, I pressed one button to make it all happen and disappear. I guarantee by the end of this video, you're going to be doing the same. So let's get going. It's overused now. Whatever. Before we begin anything, update your OBS Studio to the latest version. I've had so many people mention how they can't find plugins after installing, so just make sure your OBS Studio is up to date. I try to make the installation process of plugins, which is easy by the way, for the most part, as clear as possible. So if you're having issues, even after that, reinstall OBS Studio, and hopefully that should solve any problems of things not showing up. Moving on, step one. Before opening OBS Studio, we're going to need to install the Lua and the plugin. To do the instant replay, we're going to need an instant replay Lua file, which you can download here. Link is also in the description. We want to place it within this path of our OBS Studio directory. Next, we want to download the move plugin from here and extract the zip contents to the OBS Studio folder, where it's all going to be placed accordingly into your directory. I should note that these plugins are made by the incredible Exeldro, who also made the replay source plugin I used in the freeze frame tutorial. He's an incredible developer, very responsive, and constantly updating his plugins with new features. We're lucky to have him working within OBS Studio, I would say, so support him however you can. He rocks. Okay, good. All set up? Great. Let's get OBS Studio up and running. We've got our OBS Studio open, and we've got our typical scene where we're going to want to pop up replays. It could be our gameplay, our webcam, or a blend of both. It's totally up to you. Create a brand new scene and call it Instant Replay Scene. In here, add a media source. For now, we're just going to set it to loop, but we're going to be coming back to switch this off. Set it to close when inactive, hit OK, and rename this Instant Replay Source. Next, we need to set up that instant replay Lua that we installed. Go to Tools and down to Scripts. In here, we want to hit the plus button and add the instant replay Lua from the directory that pops up. Next, select it and set up the media source to select instant replay source. The interval equals the milliseconds between checks for a new replay save being completed in the memory, and the maximum attempt segment relates to how much time is between each check. So, in this case, I have my interval set to 1000 milliseconds, or 1 second. I've left the max attempts at 5, and the replace playlist checkbox is unchecked. So for every 5 seconds, the Lua will check to see if the replay has been saved. The replay playlist is for a VLC player source, and it can add the replay to the playlist of that VLC player source, or replace the playlist entirely with a new replay. We'll not be doing that in this example, so you can leave that unchecked if you wish. Once those are set up, hit close. Now we've done that, we want to set up our replay buffer. Go to Settings, then Output, and to the Replay Buffer tab. Be sure to enable this, set your replay duration. I'm hoping to catch roughly 8 second replays here, so I'm going to set mine to 10 seconds, simply because it's good to have a bit of extra time to avoid getting cut off. Go to the Recording tab and set up the video settings for your recordings. All instant replays captured will follow these settings, and the recording directory you set is where they're going to go as well. Here's my settings. It might seem like overkill, but it's handy to have high quality clips if you want to make edits for YouTube or an intro for your Twitch. Next, we want to go to the General tab and check Automatically Start Replay Buffer When Streaming. This way, you don't have to think about the replay buffer being started once you're live. It'll just begin, and you'll not need to worry about hitting that instant replay capture later and missing a replay because your buffer wasn't running. So that's great. While we're still in here, we're going to go down to the hotkeys and set a hotkey for the instant replay. If you have a Stream Deck, at this point I would recommend setting up a hotkey on that. From the drop-down menu under a hotkey setting on your Stream Deck, select one of the function keys. I've chose F13 in this case. Highlight the instant replay field in the hotkey segment of OBS Studio and hit the newly made hotkey, after which it should update as OBS_key_F13. I find this really useful for hotkeying keys that I don't actually have on my keyboard, so it means that there's little chance of that hotkey doing some funky stuff while I'm streaming. If you don't have a Stream Deck, simply set this bind to whatever you wish. You can use combination binds to do Control Shift and any number of the function buttons, for example. That's always a good shout. Though maybe avoid Alt and F4. Okay, done? Great. Now we have a new button, Start Replay Buffer. And it's running. Well, it should be running. If it isn't, click it. Let's get it running. Since we've never generated a replay, we need to make one to get started. Click this and the replay buffer will start. What the buffer does is it continually records the last 10 seconds of my OBS feed, keeping it in my computer's memory. You can adjust this by selecting a longer interval of time within your replay buffer settings. I'm not entirely sure on this, but if you adjust it, it might be worth restarting the replay buffer just to make sure that it updates to the newly entered interval. If you've got it set to 10 seconds, for example, wait at least 10 seconds after starting the buffer before saving a replay. It can't save before that, and we'll need a video file to set up some things in the following steps. Click the Save Replay button here. The recording path we set earlier in the Recordings tab is where you're going to find that newly made replay. Go back to the instant replay scene we made, and in Instant Replay Source, we want to locate that replay video we just made. Select it, once that's done, hit OK. Alright, so we've made an instant replay scene with our instant replay source in it, and it's currently playing a replay we've made on loop. We've created a hotkey to capture an instant replay as well. Awesome. But where does that show up? Currently only in the instant replay scene. But that is about to change. Take the scene you'd like the replays to pop up in. Here's a typical full screen webcam scene. Duplicate the entire scene and change the affix of it to say replay display, for example. It doesn't matter what you name yours, just make it clear that it's a version of that scene, but for displaying replays. Once we've done that, we're going to add the instant replay scene to this new duplicate, proceeding to reposition and resize the instant replay scene somewhere within this scene that we're happy with. Before we do that though, I would recommend right-clicking newly nested scene, going to Edit Transform, and switching this field to Center. After which you can do all the repositioning and sizing for the instant replay scene as you would like it to appear when calling up replays. Seven steps. I hope you're still with me. The great stuff is just around the corner. So, remember that Move plugin we installed? Yeah, it's time to get that set up. Go to the Scene Transitions tab and in the drop-down menu, select Move. If it's not there, simply hit the plus button and you can add it. This transition plugin actually moves things around your scene, taking note of position and size of the scene, sources within the scene, but also sources that are not within the scene. That is what we want to focus on right now. So, scroll down and we can see appearing items. This section here is where we focus on items which are not in one scene setup, but are in the next. The easing settings are entirely up to you. I personally would leave ease in and out as your easing setting and play around with the easing function, as there's a lot of cool styles in here. I'll leave position and transition at none and curve at zero. I'll be doing a video going through this plugin in much more depth soon, but for now, hit OK. Now, when you switch between your normal scene and the duplicate that has the instant replay scene nested in it, this happens.
Boom!
Yeah. Pretty cool. No? Yes, it's cool. You know it's cool. So we can hit our instant replay button, we can capture an instant replay, we can then switch to that scene at our own leisure, and it pops up, showing our instant replay. Fantastic stuff. However, I want more than that. I want what I did in the intro. Duplicate the replay scene again, and in the new duplicate name, call it replay full screen or replay zoom. Unlock the instant replay scene nested in this new duplicate, and let's make it bigger. You can full screen it if you want, or just increase the size of it a good bit. To get the centering just right, I usually right click, transform, and center to screen. That looks good to me. One more thing. Go back to the instant replay scene and the instant replay source and switch off looping. We only needed the video to loop while we got the sizing and the positioning right. If you're happy with all that, then you're sorted. If not, you can always go back and enable the loop again until you get the size and position where you're happy. Now, let's hop onto the Stream Deck and make some magic happen.
Magic!
Here on the Stream Deck, I have a few things set up. So I have a simple scene switch for my basic scene without the replay here, followed by an instant replay multi-action. And what we're going to do is take a look at how that multi-action is set up. So you can see that it begins with the hotkey we made earlier for making an instant replay, followed by a 500 millisecond delay. You can make this longer if you want. I just like to give OBS a moment to process things before writing into the next command. And then have 8500 milliseconds or 8.5 second delay, but not all of it, as I want to then return to my original scene by the end, creating a nice overall look and not leaving the replay suddenly disappearing on my screen. Aesthetically, this is going to look way better. Next, I have a reload replay button. The instant replay multi-action we've made will always bring up the replay you've just made after you hit this button and capture it. Whereas this button is there to bring up the last replay you just made if you wanted to watch it again. I have a slight delay at the start, followed by a scene switch, 8.5 second delay, and then return to the original scene. Here is a save replay hotkey. It's the hotkey we made earlier, so if you simply wanted to save the replay but not view it right there and then, you can have this as an option. This is my personal favorite, and it's what you saw at the start of this video. It's the same as reload replay, however we add on another scene switch within. Since our overall duration of the clip being shown is going to be around 8.5 seconds, we split the timing up amongst these delays so you can have 1.5 seconds on the normal replay and 7 on the larger replay before it returns to scene 1. You can do this with instant replays as well. Simply put the hotkey for instant replay in the very top of this multi-action before everything, and that's that. It'll be perfect.